Thank you for coming. We really appreciate your attendance and participation. Don't be shy. Come on over. If everybody can gather over here in front of the camera. Come on. You're making it. A little further. Can you hear me better? All right. Louder? Come on over, folks. Come on right over in front of the podium, please. We're going to get started in just a minute.
Where am I supposed to be?
Madeline, you're up here with us. Hey, how are you?
If we could have all elected officials and honorary guests, please join us up here on the stage. All right, come on in, folks. Marion, come on up. Are we missing any other elected or honorary guests here with us? All right, come on in with your signs. They look great, all fantastic. Yeah. So my name's Chad, and I'm very grateful to have you here with us tonight. I'm both with the Salon Democrats and also Schenectady LGBT Pride. And we're very grateful to have all of you here with us to be part of this special event. I don't know that we've ever had an LGBT rally here in front of City Hall before, so this is exciting for all of us. And we're very grateful for everyone showing up, including our elected officials and special guests and candidates. So I'm not here to speak. I just want to get you all here, get you revved up a little bit. So we got a little song we're going to play. Go ahead and hit it, Spiro. Just to get us revved up, get us in the spirit a little bit. I don't know if anybody's heard of A Great Big World before, but it's a great song, and it just kind of gets the energy going and reminds us what we're here to do. And we did a voter drive, Get Out the Vote, last year, and we had some young people come here in front of City Hall, and they danced their little hearts out, and we taped it, and we put it on YouTube. And they did a great job, and encourage people to go out and do what's important, which is to vote. And for all of you that don't know, this coming Tuesday, September 9th, is the primary, so make sure you get out there and vote in the primary. And also, the November election coming up on November 4th, right?
Yes.
So,
you can turn it up. That's as loud as it goes.
I'll let the song speak, and then we'll get started.
We had each other.
Yeah, you bet. Anyway.
All right, Lisa.
I follow that act, Lisa.
I'm going to move the microphone way down. Thank you all for being here. I will give you my apologies first and foremost because I squeezed this in between two things because it was really, really important for me to be here tonight. But when I speak, I have to kind of scoot off. So I'm with you in spirit, and it's not for a lack of knowing how important this really is. I just want to take a minute to recognize the people that are here, that are elected officials, people also running for office. We have our county legislature chair, Tony Jasinski. City Council President Margaret King, and Council Members John Mutavirin, and also Marion Porterfield, and Ed Kosher. We have a Council Candidate John Ferrari with us today. And we also have several candidates for Family Court Judge, Jill Polk, also Patricia Rodriguez. And I think I got everyone. I mentioned your name. Yeah. And then, of course, we have our candidate for State Senate, which you'll hear from later, Madeline Thorne. And and our Senator, Cece Catchett.
Yes.
So here's the important stuff. I have a transgender stepchild. I fooled myself into thinking that his life was normal. He's married, works in a cafe, has a beautiful baby girl, and is always happy and positive. Normal, right? Then I found out that people say things to him like, "I don't know what you are. Am I supposed to call you he, she, what?" And he graciously responds, "Well, you could just call me Chris." In the summer, he manages a snack bar at a campground. The management of the campground makes him walk more than a half mile to use the restroom on the outskirts that no one else uses. He's not allowed to use the restroom that the other employees and campers use. These things break my heart. These things send a message to Chris that he is not normal. Who gets to decide that? I have a business owner friend who received a call a couple of years ago. The caller explained that she had been angry about the owner's appearance for a long time, and now she was going to say something about it. She went on to explain she didn't like the way the owner dressed, wore her hair. It wasn't professional. She also said that she admired her work and that she did a great job, but her appearance just wasn't normal, and she should change it. The caller apparently was sure that she knew normal. When I brought gender support resolution to the council, a constituent used privilege of the floor to chastise me and express that protecting the rights of transgender people was not city business. Isn't it everyone's business to protect humankind from harm? Surely that should be normal. One of my business colleagues thought she was being supportive and said how brave she thought I was to bring the legislation forward and to disclose that I had a transgender stepchild. Brave? Someone showing unconditional love, support, and acceptance is brave? Isn't that just normal? We need to extend the human rights law to include gender identity and expression. The Gender Expression Non-Discrimination Act, or GENDA, has been stalled for 13 years. GENDA secures basic civil rights for transgender and gender non-conforming New Yorkers so that no one is fired from their job or kicked out of their home because of legal or transphobic discrimination. When polled, nearly 80% of New Yorkers agree that GENDA should become law. So who gets to decide what normal is? I'd like normal to be defined as being the best person you can be, being kind to one another, and accepting each other's unique qualities. To me, that's normal. Woo! And now I have the pleasure to introduce Ewan Renfro from Transgender Rights Organizer with Empire State Pride Agenda. And thank you all.
Hello, everyone. Thank you all for coming out this evening to make a public stand so that lesbian, gay, bisexual, and transgender New Yorkers have a voice in the New York State Senate. I am, as was just said, Ewan Renfro, the transgender rights organizer for the Empire State Pride Agenda. It's my honor to represent New York's statewide LGBT civil rights and advocacy organization, and to reiterate our endorsement of these stellar candidates for New York State Senate, Cecilia Ketchik and Madeline Thorne. Give them a hand. Great. So why? Why is a pro-LGBT Senate so important? I am one reason. As a transgender man, right here, right now in Schenectady County, I am not protected. I am a second-class citizen. In 1945, New York was the first state in the Union to prohibit discrimination with the passage of the original Human Rights Law. The law has been continually revisited and updated over the years in order to uphold its purpose, which is to afford every citizen an equal opportunity to enjoy a full and productive life. The Gender Expression Non-Discrimination Act, or GENDA, would be the latest update, adding gender identity and expression to the list of protected classes under the law. No person can be said to have an equality of opportunity if they can be denied housing just for who they are or how they look. If they can be denied a job, if they can be denied education, if they can be denied the simple right of sitting down in a restaurant to eat, but here in Schenectady County, doing any or all of these things to me or any other transgender person would be completely legal. And that's the case throughout most of New York State. That's why we need GENDA. And that's why we need to elect a Senate that won't keep pushing transgender people and our allies to the side. GENDA is important because transgender lives are important. How can we push back against one of the most violent and murderous summers for transgender women of color on record if transgender people don't have legal equality? How can we advocate for the thousands of homeless transgender youth across the state, refugees from families who abuse them or kick them out because of who they are, if the state agrees that those teenagers really aren't equal and don't deserve protections? How can any one of us be proud of our state if so many of us have to live in fear? So what can we all do? Number one, of course, as everyone here knows, vote right here with us. We've got pro-gender, pro-LGBT candidates, and all of them need your votes to make it into office. Madeline Thorne is battling a longtime opponent of GENDA and an ugly denier of transgender equality. Cecilia Ketchik won her last election by 18 votes. 18. Votes do matter, and every single vote counts. Bring a friend, or five, or 10 to the polls with you. Bring a transgender friend with you. They may need the support. And the boots on the ground work needs to get done too. Volunteer for a campaign. Phone bank for an hour or two a week. Knock on doors and remind people to vote this Tuesday. Then remind them again in November. If you can't do it, donate some money so that people can be hired to knock on doors and call up voters in your stead. We need a pro-LGBT Senate to guarantee that a grandmother can't be kicked out of her nursing home for wearing clothes and makeup that someone else doesn't approve of. We need a pro-LGBT Senate so a veteran who served his country can't be fired from his job after his employer finds out he was discharged for being transgender. And we need a pro-LGBT Senate so when another child becomes homeless because their parents couldn't accept them for who they are, there is someone who cares about them, who believes their life is valuable in the government that is supposed to represent and protect them. New York needs GENDA, and we here have the power to make that need a reality in 2015. Thank you. It is now my pleasure to introduce Allison McLean Lane, who is representing the Assemblymember Phil Steck and also the Albany County Legislature. Please give her a hand. Thank you.
Hard acts to follow, I have to say. Again, my name is Allison McLean Lane, and I'm here representing somebody who I really am proud to work for, Assemblymember Phil Steck. He's very sorry he could not be here today. He is in Washington, D.C., attending to his business as an attorney in private practice. Assemblymember Phil Steck is a civil rights attorney whose cases include representing members of the LGBT community in discrimination cases. The transgendered community is a very important part of the 110th Assembly District, indeed all human life. And Assemblymember Steck is proud to stand with you as a legislator in support of your civil rights. Equal protection under the laws for all is all we ask for. The New York State Assembly has passed GENDA 6 times, and Assemblymember Steck looks forward to working with other progressive Democrats in the Senate, such as these here today, to ensure passage of GENDA in the New York State Senate. On a personal note, in my role as an Albany County legislator, my proudest moment in elective office was my absolute yes vote to include gender identity as a protective class in our omnibus human rights law. If the Albany County legislature can do it and do it unanimously with a Republican minority, I am confident that the New York State legislature can do it too. I thank you very much. I would like to introduce the next speaker, Lauren Ford, with the Pride Center of the Capital Region. She is the LGBT health specialist.
Thank you. They have like a little podium. They must have known none of us are really that tall. I shouldn't try to adjust it. I'll just go down, I guess. So hello, my name is Lauren Ford, and I'm the LGBT health specialist at the Pride Center. Our main office is in Albany, but we actually serve 11 counties. So if you drew a map of New York State and had around anywhere from 60 miles in any direction from our building, that's the area that we serve. We serve more than just Albany or Albany County. And in my role at the Pride Center, I'm in charge of our center support program, which I could talk about for 3 days, but I won't. And one of the programs I wanted to talk to you guys about, because it stresses the need for a broad support of equality for all people, especially transgender and gender nonconforming folks, is our case management services, which celebrated its second birthday this July. Case management services fills a really vital need in our community, and 60% of my clients identify as being transgender or gender nonconforming. And 92% of my clients identify as living in poverty. That's a humongous amount of folks who are really struggling to meet their needs, who are struggling with homelessness, who are struggling with discrimination, who are struggling with mental health issues. And these issues just don't exist in a bubble. It's not like, oh, well, you're just more likely because you are. These issues, because for reasons. One of these reasons why these issues are so prevalent in our community is because of discrimination in employment and discrimination in education and discrimination in the home. Housing is healthcare. That's something I've really learned a lot in my role here at the Pride Center, is that people who are routinely kicked out of their house or refused to see an apartment or refused credit at a bank because their gender doesn't match up with what it says on paper for who they are, that has lasting effects on transgender folks. And it's not just a New York City issue, and it's not just an Albany County issue, it's an issue for our state. And many of my clients live in outlying areas and ask me, am I protected where I live? And I have to say no, that you're not. And we know that laws don't necessarily make everything sunshine and rainbows immediately, but we know that we need a broad support for our community on all levels of government. And I'm so proud that we are moving forward in that area. And I look forward to the day when case management services aren't needed. The point of social work is to work yourself out of a job. And I would love for us to get to that point as a community where there are no health disparities for our community and where every single transgender person knows that their life matters. And the folks that I work with every day don't always know that because they don't hear those messages. And they do deal with violence and they deal with issues around discrimination, and they deal with sexual assault and responders who don't know how to respond to them, and they deal with not knowing that they even can vote or how to do so. I could go on forever and ever and ever because it makes me so impassioned and angry and pissed off to talk about this stuff. But I am so glad to hear so many people here who want a broad base of support for our community, and we'll do whatever it takes to make that happen. So thank you so much for letting me talk. And it's my pleasure to introduce Senator Cecilia Kacik.
Hello, Schenectady. Yeah. It's great to be here, and it's great to be the senator that represents the 46th Senate District. You heard it right. I won by 18 votes in 2012. And one of the reasons I did win is because people like you voted. People like you talked to their neighbors and said, we need to get someone in the Senate who's going to represent all of us. I am very proud to be there representing every citizen in the 46th Senate District, something that my opponent in 2012, who's the same opponent now, I don't think did a good job of doing. I am appalled that we haven't passed GENDA yet. It's been 13 years. Every year my opponent was in the Assembly and had an opportunity to vote against this bill, he did. He's part of the problem. This isn't passed. He wants to go to the Senate. My race is going to be another nail biter. This district that I happen to represent was drawn by the Senate Republicans for my opponent because they thought it would be easy for him to win. They didn't count on me saying, he doesn't represent me, he doesn't represent my communities, and he's not going to do a good job in the Senate. I want someone who's going to represent me, whose vote will matter. Your vote matters in the Senate. So I sent him packing because of people like you. I don't want to win by a squeaker this time around. I want to win by a landslide. I want my nickname to be Landslide Kacik. Because we don't want to spend months fighting over opening ballots in court. We fought really hard to get me there. And I am so proud that I had the full backing of the Empire State Pride Agenda and their financial support. And I am proud to be a co-sponsor of GENDA. And this is a bill we need to pass because we need to stand up for human rights. It is not okay to discriminate against anyone for any reason. Why would we continue to send the message because we don't pass this law that it's okay to discriminate against people? This is frankly just wrong. I can't get this passed, however, if we don't have a few more people who take this issue seriously and want to stand up and do something about it. People like Madeline Thorne need to join me in the Senate so we have a clear Senate Democratic majority. Only then will this bill get to the floor, and only then can we pass it. Please help me. There's a clipboard over there. You can not only vote, you can help volunteer. You can help us knock on doors, make phone calls. There'll be folks at that table. Please join us. And also, please help our next senator, Madeline Thorne, join me. Come on up here, Madeline. And join me and Senator Neil Breslin, who was planning to be here but unfortunately could not be here, and sends his regards. He would be here if he could. Please help us get GENDA passed. You're the ones who will get it to the floor this coming year. Thank you. Here's Madeline, our next senator representing Schenectady.
Thank you, Senator. Thank you, Senator Kacik. Thank you all for coming out this evening. There we go. I want to thank Chad and all of the other great people that pulled this wonderful event together. I feel so biblical. I am Madeline Thorne, the endorsed Democratic candidate, and I am running to be your senator in the 49th district. When I have the opportunity to join Senator Kachik, Senator Breslin, and our other Democratic colleagues in the Senate, we will work together for the passage of JENDA. Thank you, Senator Kachik, for all of your support, all of your generosity, for your ethics, for your open heart, for your passion, for your compassion. Senator Kachik, I have seen her in action. She speaks truth to power. I predict that one day she will be in our books as the great Senator Kachik. But we need to all work together. We need to keep Senator Kachik in the Senate. We need her there. It would be almost impossible to overstate how important this gets.